Dear student, today we will discuss another case study to design ERD or draw ERD in Microsoft Visio. In this one case study, we are having the different type of the entity. Let me start the Microsoft Visio. Okay, click on basic diagrams. Create, and we want to use it. Select more shapes. We want to select it over here. Shapes, software, and databases. And in databases, cross-footed notations. That is selected. Now select the change the designs. Let me say change the size, orientation. That should be a landscape. Fine. Size, let me say that should be a legal or A3, or change it to the legal. Okay. Now, as per case study, patients are identified by social security numbers, their names, address, date of birth, age. That must be recorded. Let me see that entity type name is here patients. So we have to create one entity. Patient that is here. Now we see that attribute should be here, like we are having the identified by social security number. So identifier of this one must be social security number, SSN. So for the here it says it's primary key. Fine, primary key and identifier are the same. That is used for the unique identification of the ERD. Next one, we are having the name. First alphabet of any attribute must be the uppercase letter. Let me see that name is composed of. Name is a composite attribute and that containing the first names, and last names. So we can use it over here. We can consider it over here, first name and last name. Composite attribute, so then we have to use the parenthesis. Then we use the first names. And then we are having the last name. And close the parenthesis. Okay, this one is our ERD two attribute. Next one, we are having the address, so we want to use it over here, address. If we have to add the new attribute, here we are having attribute is here. Drag it and drop it with this one entity. Next one attribute must be here, date of birth and age. It's that next attribute should be here, date of birth. Date of birth is a store attribute, and next attribute it's that it's the age. Age value must be calculated from the date of birth. So age is a derived attribute. For derived attribute, we have to use the bracket. That we see addresses, patient have more than one address and we want to store all of those addresses, so that is called multi-value attribute. Then for that one we have to use the curly braces. This one is the patient entity. If we checked, next one entity we are having the doctor. Doctor identified by social security numbers, so drag the entity and drop it over here. Doctor, again social security number, that is the identifier. Then other attributes, the name and specialty. We are having the name of doctor. We are not using it over here, any other. And next one we are having the artificiality. And year of experience must be recorded. That we are using, we want to use it over here, the joining date and year of experience. Okay, sorry, the spellings of the speciality are the wrong. So I have to use the correct spelling. Then we are having the joining date or hire date. And then we are having the year of experience. Experience year or year of experience. Experience year. So that must be calculated from the hire date. So that is a derived attribute. Next one, another entity, that is a pharmaceutical company. So just this one entity is here. How we can use it? And entity, drag it and drop it. Just I write the take the names over here. If we want to take it in the same order, so format painter for this one. Okay, now for this one we are having the different attributes. Identifier is the name of the company and other attributes are phone numbers. We are having here name and here other attributes are here phone. Is there any other attribute? No other attribute for this one. So fine, just if we have more attribute options are there, we can remove those options. Like this one attribute, we don't need it, so just remove it. Next one, we are having another entity, that is a drug. So drag it and drop it over here. We are having the drug. So for the headphones, what should be? Trade name should be, let me say that, that should be the identifier. So we have to use it over here. Trade names. First alphabet must be the uppercase letter. If we are having the two words for the attribute names, then we have to use the underscore between both names. Then we are having for the drugs another formula. No other attribute is here. Now next one, we see that drug is sold by the given pharmaceutical company and trade name is identifier of the drug uniquely from the product of their company. Fine. Next one, we are having the pharmacy. Let me draw another entity over here. That is a pharmacy. Attribute for the pharmacy are name, address and phone number. If name, that must be unique. Okay, if not unique, then we can use it over here, pharmacy ID or any other. Address of the pharmacy and phone number. Of the pharmacy. These are the main entities are available over here. Now, it said that every patient has a primary physician. Primary physician means doctors. Patient has a doctor. And every doctor have at least one patient. Now we are having the relationship among the patient and doctors, and that is, it see that we are having, every patient have a doctors, our primary physicians. We see that one patient having exactly one doctor, our physicians, while one doctor have zero or many patient. If we check it over here, it see that each doctor at least one patient, so minimum cardinality should be here for the doctors. We see that one or more patient, one patient has primary physician, so we can use it over here, the name of the relationship has, and then the doctors has one patient. Now next one, pharmacy sells several drug and has a price for the each. Now we see that pharmacy sells drug, so we are having the relationship between the pharmacy and drug. So that is, we say that each pharmacy sold several drug. Now when we say that each pharmacy sells several drugs, one drug is sells by, there any, a drug could be sold by several pharmacies, and price could vary from one pharmacy to another pharmacy. So we see that drug could be sold by several pharmacy. Let me see that drug is there, that is sold by, here we see that can be sold by zero or many pharmacy. Let, we are having any drug is there, that is in the trial phase, so we are having no pharmacy is there. But when we see that it is sold by many pharmacy, so definitely we have to use the attribute on the relationship, and that is the price. Price that does not belong to any participating entity types. So whenever we have to use the attribute on the relationship, and that is sell. How we can that is the price. How we can use, whenever we are having attribute on the relationship, then we have to use the associative entity type. So instead of this one, we have to use another entity types over here, that is entity type, drag it and drop it over here, so it become the associative entity types. So what we are having, we say that pharmacy drug sales . And for this one, we are having one attribute is here. We say that price, right? It may be possible that they may have the quantity, so that is not mentioned over here. We are not using it over here. Okay, price value can be vary from one pharmacy to another pharmacy. It we can use for the identifier of this one entity type. We can, this one entity type may have its own identifier, or we can use the identifier of the participating entity type, that can become the identifier of this associative entity types. And this one is a drug sale, is a associative entity types. We have to use the rounded corner, so right click, format shape, and then we are having the lines are available, so here we have to use the rounded shape should be here, so this one, that is little rounded corner associative entry type. No other attribute, finds it. Okay, next ones we have doctor prescribe drug for patients. Now, here we are having the relationship among the three different entity types. Doctor prescribe drug for the patients. The doctor could prescribe one or more drug for the several patient, and a patient could obtain prescription from several doctors. That has a debt in quantity. So now, relationship is here between the three different entity types: doctor, drug, and patients. When three entity types are participating in a relationship, that relationship is called tertiary relationship. And whenever we are having tertiary relationship, then we have to use the associative entity types. And the name of associative entity type, that is the prescriptions. So we have to use another relationship, that is the prescriptions. That is associative entity type. Now here we may have the primary of the participating entity type, that social security, patient security, social security numbers, doctor social security numbers, and drug trade numbers. Or we say that's a prescriptions ID. We can use this one associative entity types, its own numbers. Now this one relationship is here. This now relationship, drag the relationship over here. This and last ones we are having the with the so prescription is here. Now it's have its own attribute, data, dates, and quantity. In prescriptions, we are having the concept of the date and quantity. Let's hang down. So whenever we are having the prescriptions is here, okay, now it's clear. Now here we have to use the dates and we are having the quantity of the drugs. These are the attribute for the associative entity. Now this one is the associative entity type. Definitely then we are having the rounded corner shape format, and then we have to use the in the lines, then we have to use this one symbol. This will display the rounded corner. Now patient has a primary physician or doctor. Now this one is a prescription is a associative entity type, then we are not using the line labeled lines. Here we are having the prescription is associative entity types, no need to mention the line. Similarly drug sales, this one is again we are having the associative entity types, no use to mention it over here. Now next one we are having pharmaceutical companies as long-term contact with the pharmacies. So we are having pharmaceutical companies have a contract with pharmacies. A pharmaceutical company can contract with the several pharmacy, and a pharmacy can contract with the several pharmaceutical company. So mean one we are having each pharmacy may have zero or many contract with pharmaceutical companies, while each pharmaceutical company may have contract with the many pharmacy. So again we are having the many to many relationship among the pharmacy and pharmaceutical company. So whenever we have a many-to-many relationship among the two different entity types, then again we have to use the associative entity types. And so here we are having the new associative entity type, that is a contract. The name of entry type must be uppercase letter. So we said it's we are using its own identifier, contract ID. Now we said it's relationship is here. Now whenever we are having associative entry types, on the associative entry types sides we always have many sides, while other entry types, whenever we are having the many to many relationship, we have to broke down many to many relationship and two one to many relationships. So then again always on the associative entry types we are having the many sides. Now what are the main attribute of this one? We see that for each contract we are having the start date, end date and the text for the contract. So we have to use the start date. Start date. Next one we have to use the end date. That's and another attribute that we see, that's the text. So these are the different entities are available as per the descriptions or case study statements. Now this one is the associative entity type. Right click and then format shape. Then we have to use it over a rounded presence, so that will be moved over here. Now here we are having the our complete ER diagrams. Let me reduce the size so it show as per the description. So as per statements here we are having the ERD and which patient, doctor, drug, pharmacy, pharmaceutical company, right? These are the different type of the entities are here. And then having the associative entity types, these are the prescriptions and contract. Thanks for watching the video.